Are you needing a better way to manage all of your tasks? Are you needing a to-do list solution that really works for you? Well, in today's video, I'm going to show you 5 different ways to create a custom to-do list right here within Trello. And we're going to start simple and we're going to work our way up to something that I call the ultimate to-do list for Trello. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And we're going to start with the default here. When you open up or start a brand new board in Trello, most likely you'll have these 3 lists waiting for you: to do, doing, and done. And that gives us a great way to work through sort of a Kanban style method of dragging things through the process until they are complete. Now, you can add due dates if you want to keep yourself on task, but a pretty simple way to get started here with managing your tasks within Trello. Why don't we turn it up a notch and go to level 2? Those of you who may be familiar with the book Getting Things Done, also known as GTD, know that it can be helpful to group certain tasks together. So for example, if I've got something here like review customer feedback survey, let's say that's something that I'm gonna do at my computer, I'm gonna add a label. I'm gonna add a label called computer. And you can see here that I've already pre-created a number of labels. I've got about 5 here: email, phone, errand, meeting, and computer. Because what I want to be able to do is quickly identify things that are, for example, all of my phone calls, so I can get them all done in roughly the same time, within the same batch of time, and then move on to something else. So let's group a few of these here. Workout at the gym, well, that's certainly an errand. I'm not doing that at the office. Hire new staff, that's going to be a phone interview, so I'm going to say 2 there. Decide on a website budget, that's computer related. Redesign website. Call long lost friend. Yeah, that's definitely a phone call. So I'm going to put that as a phone call there. So the nice thing here is that if I go up to show menu, I can choose the search cards option. And let's say I just want to work on the things that are at my computer. Well, I can select that label and now everything else is hidden. So for the next half hour or next hour, whatever that bulk of time happens to be, I can just focus on these 3 areas. If I'm done with that, I can go back here and let's say, hey, I've got a few minutes to make a few phone calls. Let's go to the phone. And now I can focus on just these tasks. So the combination of adding different labels and then using the search cards option to filter things out can be a great way to up your productivity. Now, I'm just going to reduce these labels. I'm going to minimize these labels if I click on them, just so we can focus more on the tasks. Why don't we step it up a notch once again? And something that you may need within your to-do list system is the ability to add subtasks, right? So, for example, review customer feedback survey. Maybe there's a few different things that I need to get done here. Well, if I open up this card, a great way to add subtasks is to add a checklist. So if I add a checklist in here, and I'm just going to call this one subtasks for our example, I'm going to say add. Now what I can do is I can add a bunch of smaller tasks within this. I'm just going to use a few examples just so that we have a few to look at here. So let's say that there are 3 subtasks that I need to complete for this particular task. I can come in here, I can list them, and I can start checking them off. And the great thing is that on the front of the card, you get a nice little icon that shows me, hey, I'm 2/3 of the way done. When I'm, all 3 done here, I can then move this over to the done list, but I'm still not quite finished here. If I go back in here and I finish task number 3, hey, that's great. I get the little green label, and now I can move it over here to done. But let me show you one other thing that you want to keep in mind with using the task or the checklist function. Let's say as I'm, working out these tasks, I realize that, task number 3 is actually a bit bigger than I thought. This might have some of its own subtasks as well. Well, don't forget that you can break out anything within a checklist. So if I come over here and select the 3 dots, I can say convert to card. And so now when I go outside of this card, here you can see task number 3 is now its own task, its own card within this list. So some things that can start within a checklist, if it's a subtask, for example, you can break it out to its own task if necessary. All right, well, so far we've only been working with 3 different lists here, but why don't we add something else, which I think is very valuable, and that is a projects list. So I'm going to add a new list, and I'm going to bring it all the way over here to the left-hand side. And something that is often missing is that as we go about planning our day, we start to analyze and prioritize all the things that we would like to get done here. However, often what we get done or where we focus our attention is not necessarily in line with the projects, the big goals that we should be accomplishing. So let me just add a few here. I'm going to say project 1 and project 2, just for example here. So not only am I going to have them listed here in my projects list, and yes, you will definitely have more than 2 projects on the go at any given time, not only can I just reference it and look at it, so when I'm looking at the things that I want to be doing today or that I should be doing this week, not only can I look over here, but we want to go one step further and actually connect some of these tasks to these projects. So I'm going to open up project number 1. And let's say that some of the things that are already in my to-do list are related to project number 1. What I can do is go over here and select attachment. I'm going to select Trello, and you can see that it actually has some of the most recent cards that I have selected or viewed. So let's say review customer feedback survey is one of those tasks. Hey, now it appears here within this project. Let's do it one more time because there's probably more than one thing that is related to this project. Now I'm going to go over here and I'm going to say, well, that new book is also related to project number 1. So now I have both of those tasks listed here. You can see on the front of that card, on the front of my project card, you can see that there's 2 things. I can see that there are 2 tasks assigned or related here. And when I open it up, not only do I see a nice preview of these 2, but if I click on them, it takes me directly to that card, directly to that task. So it's a great way to create those relationships between your daily tasks or your actionable tasks and the overarching project, and keeping track which one of those are related to this given project. All right, so we added one more list here, but I'm going to actually convert this one last time. We're going to add 2 more lists, and we're going to see if that's going to help us be that much more efficient. So the first one that I'm going to add is called notes. Sometimes I call it notes/ideas. And I'm going to add one more here, and it's called waiting for. Okay, and I'm going to put them in a few different places here. The notes I'm going to bring all the way over to the left, just to the left of projects. And my waiting for, I'm going to put here between doing and done. So let's start with the notes and ideas. Often we don't think of Trello as a good note-taking tool, but remember, all of these cards, let's just put in a test card here, for example, all of these cards give you the ability to attach documents, to attach a image, to, you know, have full comments, and if there's other people involved, such as a meeting agenda, you can include that here as well. Whether it's checklists and due dates, it's a great place to add all of those notes, especially here in the description area. And remember, many of the notes that you take will never become a task or become a project, but if they do, how easy is it to just drag it over into the projects list? Or if it's a task, to just drag it over into your to-do list. You've already got all of that information. You've got everything that you need within that given card. And remember, you can also forward your emails directly to this list. So if you come across other ideas or valuable pieces of information, you can forward that directly here into your Trello board. So I think having a notes or an ideas list is a great idea. Now, moving over to our waiting for list, I like to have a waiting for or a pending list. It could be called pending if you like, somewhere between the doing and done list. Because let's be honest, sometimes you're working on something and it's simply out of your hands for a period of time. So let's say hire new staff. Let's say, you know, you're still waiting for more applications to come in. There's really nothing you can do at this given point. There's nothing you can actionably do except for maybe just wait till the end of the week or whatever that time frame is for those applications to come in. So I think it's nice to have that separation between things that you can actionably do here and things that you can review maybe at the end of the day or from time to time. See if you need to give someone a nudge. Maybe you're waiting to hear back from someone. That's a great thing to put in a waiting for list. And either it may return back to the doing list, or when it's finished, you can move it over to done. So I think the waiting for list is a great one as well. The list, or I should say the board that you see here, is something that I refer to as the ultimate to-do list for Trello. And if you don't want to waste your time building out this list yourselves, you can make a copy of it. Please see the link in the description below so that you can create your very own copy of this Trello board, and then you can do whatever you want with it. You can add other lists, you can change the labels, you can do whatever you want to help you stay more productive. Well, thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope that you leave me a comment, and if you have any further questions, let me know down below. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.